Should organ donation be compulsory? Who should own your body when you die? The first successful organ transplant took place in 1954 when a man offered his twin brother a kidney. The first transplant from a deceased donor occurred 8 years later. In the US alone, there are 117,000 people waiting for an organ. Of these people, as much as 60% will die while on the list. On average, every 10 minutes someone is added to the waiting list. And on average, 22 people die each day while waiting for a transplant. A single donor can save 8 lives. However, only 3 in 1,000 people die in a way that allows for organ donation. And while 95% of US adults support organ donation, only 54% are donors. The waiting list continues to grow each year at a rate that exceeds donations. If we could fix this problem, millions of lives could be saved. This is Alex from Lifelong Learners, and today I'm going to share how we can save lives by increasing organ donation rates. To do this, we need to address the root cause of low donor rates: explicit consent. Explicit consent is a system used in many countries. It means people must take some concrete steps to demonstrate that they want to be donors. The key issue with this is that many people who are willing to donate fail to take the steps. A US study found that 97% of respondents support organ transplants. However, only 43% of respondents had enrolled to have their organs donated. The steps necessary to register for organ donation deter otherwise willing donors. From an economist's perspective, there is a simple solution: permit a market for organs. Although this idea has some merit, it is also spectacularly unpopular. The World Health Organization has many examples of how organ markets have exploited vulnerable people in developing countries. A bartering system could be an acceptable solution. Suppose that you and I both need a kidney, and each of us has a sibling who is willing to donate but doesn't have the same blood type. If my sibling was a match for you, and yours was a match for mine, then a trade could be set up. This bartering system does raise the question: why is it socially acceptable for this trade, but unacceptable for me to offer to buy your sibling a new car in exchange for their kidney? An alternative to the bartering system is routine removal. This is the most aggressive approach. The state owns all rights to body parts of people who are dead or deemed to be in certain hopeless situations. Organs could be removed without asking anyone's permission. This was actually a policy in China for any criminals who were executed. While this system is extreme, some argue it has merit, as it would save lives without intruding on anyone who has prospect for life. Routine removal is already partly implemented in Georgia, where medical examiners are permitted to remove corneas post-mortem without asking permission. This has resulted in thousands of patients receiving sight. A more politically acceptable alternative to routine removal is presumed consent. Under this approach, everybody would be assumed to be consenting donors, but would be able to register their unwillingness to donate easily. Essentially, it is the same as explicit consent, but the default position is donate rather than do not donate. The default position matters a lot. Researchers found that when the default position was to be a donor, 82% of people agreed to be donors, compared to just 42% when the default was not to be a donor. This difference is also seen in countries with similar cultures, such as Germany and Austria. In Germany, which has an opt-in to donate, only 12% of people give consent, whereas in Austria, which has an opt-out to avoid donation, 99% of people are donors. The final option is mandated choice. In this model, there will be no default position. Everybody will be forced to choose to be a donor or not to be a donor. This could be part of the process of applying for a license, and the question will be compulsory. Mandated choice would most likely result in an increase in the rate of donation compared to explicit consent, but would still be lower than the presumed consent model. I believe presumed consent is the best option. While routine removal would provide higher rates of donation, presumed consent could be enough to meet demand without trampling on freedom of choice. I was inspired to make this video by the fantastic book Nudge, and a friend of mine whose mother's life was saved this year through donation. I challenge you to become an organ donor and encourage your friends and families to do the same. You could save 8 people's lives. Do you think organ donation should be mandatory? Let me know your thoughts below.
Hi everybody, Alex here. If we can change the way we enroll people to be organ donors, many lives could be saved. Hope you enjoyed the video. To subscribe to my channel, you can click here. And to check out my other content, there should be links below. Thanks for watching.